baking friends. Y'all, how cutesy are these? These are my strawberry lemonade vodka cupcakes. And if you want something tasty and delish, I can't wait to share the recipe. So thank you guys so much for watching. And before I start, I want to give a shout out real quick to Miss Monica. She gave a suggestion on my last video for me to do something with cupcakes. So here you go, Monica. And remember, you guys, to hit that subscribe button below and also leave your comment, because I'm going to be covering all the things that you guys definitely want to see. So starting off making this, we're definitely making this with love. I love chocolate and I love vanilla, but there's nothing like lemon, honey. So we're doing the creaming method, and you see there I started off with oil and sugar, and I went ahead and mixed that together. Then I'm gonna go ahead and add my egg, and this comes together so quickly. And I love using the glass bowl, because my clients always say, chef, you know, I don't have the big equipment. So this is a way for you guys to see you can use anything that you have on hand. Okay, and we're gonna go ahead and get those mixed. These are made from scratch. They're gonna be so tasty and so delish. I can't wait to see what you guys come up with. And bam, look at that, honey. We are going to be adding vodka. So the recipe is below. I have my oil and my sugar. I added the egg, and now I'm gonna add vodka. Now, here is a tip, especially for those who bake professionally. Remember, your job is to sell to your clients, honey, not yourself. So use the vodka that is good with your demographic. Don't just use the vodka that you like. My clients love Absolut, especially all my soccer moms and stuff like that. So I'm using Absolut, but I actually took a poll in my group and asked, and a lot of you guys love Ciroc, and Ciroc is good too, as well as Tito's. All right, so use whatever vodka you love. And to that, I added a little bit of a little bit of lemon, a little bit of lemon extract in the batter. My bad, we'll use strawberry later. And the batter comes together real quickly. And so what we're gonna do is go ahead and get some lemon juice, and I'm gonna go ahead and measure that. Y'all see this big ass container, y'all? You can get lemon juice from the Dollar Tree, honey. You can get damn near anything from the Dollar Tree. But if it saves you money in your business, then I say go for it. It's 100% pure, it is delicious, and you can't go wrong. And it's better than squeezing a zillion lemons. So go ahead and measure out your lemon juice and just put that to the side. I've already measured out my dry. And like I stated, this is kind of like the creaming method, even though we started with oil. If you want to sub out butter, you absolutely can. I'll have some more baking tips for you guys in the comments below. But baby, I like oil because my cakes stay moist. Okay, just gotta tell it to you, honey. So we're gonna alternate, and by doing that, that kind of ensures that all the liquid gets absorbed. Lord have mercy, Amanda. That ensures that all the liquid gets absorbed, so that these things can taste super duper yummy. Now if you see how it kind of clumps a little, don't worry, because you see towards the end, everything is going to come together perfectly, honey. Everything works out for the good of those that love to bake. I think that's like a parable or something, but anywho, so we'll go ahead and get that together. Y'all, your guests are gonna love these things. And lastly, we're going to add a little bit of zest. Now, these strawberry lemonade vodka cupcakes are inspired by a strawberry lemonade drop martini, which is a popular drink that they serve, and it usually comes with vodka and zest. So therefore, I wanted mine to have a zest. So just a little tip, you don't want to get too much of the white portion. You want to make sure that you get the colorful part of the zest in your portion, because the white has a little bit of bitter taste to it. Not in your portion, I mean in your cup. But that's that. So let's go ahead and get these together, y'all. Now I'm making these into cute little cuppies, and like I said, these have more of a pound cake consistency. This is gonna give you about 12 perfectly nice flat cupcakes. Let me repeat that again for my baking students, flat cupcakes. I don't want you to think you did anything wrong. Some batters raise differently than others. Also, you guys, you could turn these into bundt cakes if you like. I know a lot of times people are always looking for something to bake during summer weather, and these will be perfect just garnished with a little bit of powdered sugar. And you see that there? See, Do y'all liners ever kind of make that Pac-Man mouth? If they do, what you want to do is just take your finger and lightly stroke up against it. And it's cool. Liners are funny like that. And it's going to come together perfectly. And I had a little bit more, so I just went ahead and filled it. Because like I said, since I know these bake flat, I just want to go ahead and top them up so that I don't have any problems. All right. And we're going to go ahead and put these in the oven. Strawberry buttercream time. Now, I have three bonus tips for you guys towards the end, and this is one of the first ones. We have a lot of students that struggle with pricing, and by we, I mean me and my business partner. For those of you guys who have been following me, you guys know I also teach other bakers professionally, and if you did not know, I'll leave a link below so that you can get all that information. Also, if you say, hey chef, help me out in my biz, because helping bosses in their biz when they bake is something that I do. So go ahead and cut those up. And one of the things in our pricing class that we actually went over was how to lower your food waste percentage. And for those who actually bake professionally, when you're in the kitchen, you don't want to just be throwing away dollars or pennies all willy-nilly. And you do that by not monitoring your food waste. And what I say all willy-nilly is, you see these tops? I see a lot of students, when I run into you guys live and we discuss things, you just throw them away. Don't do that. Go ahead, pull those stems back, and you want to get every little piece of fruit that you can in this recipe, y'all. And this just isn't even with strawberries. You want to do this with your bell peppers and stuff too, okay? Nobody has time to be wasting no damn money. I don't know about y'all, but I sure as heck don't, especially in your kitchen. So that's just me pulling back the stems, making sure that I get every little piece of strawberry goodness, because I don't like to waste shit. All right, so go ahead and chop those up and just throw them all in there. That way you get everything you need to. Now, in this recipe, we're only going to really be using about a tablespoon. So this is going to yield you, and you'll see you only need about 4 or 5 berries that are actually going to yield you about 1/2 cup of puree when you go ahead and puree those together. And hence the word puree, okay? Not roughly chopped. You don't want no big ass pieces, because if you don't do this correctly, they're going to get stuck in your piping bag, and I'll show you that later. So this should be a nice consistency of kind of like a smoothie. Ooh, y'all, and these berries smell heavenly. I am in Louisiana. We have a city called Ponchatoula, baby, where they grow berries just fresh off the field. You could just walk right up to them and just pick them. You know, that's how we get down living in the South. Southern living at its finest. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and reserve my strawberry puree. And I'm going to put that to the side for when we make our buttercream. Now, when we're making this buttercream, see in there, you notice on the left I have butter, on the right I have high ratio shortening. For those who are more hobby bakers, if you want to use just 2 sticks of butter, you can. The rule of thumb is usually 1 cup of fat per 4 cups of powdered sugar when you are making a standard American classic buttercream. And that is what I am making. I love American buttercream, because when you do it right, baby, it comes out good, okay? So go ahead and mix that up together. And I'll be providing a link below as to where I get my shortening from. If you're like, chef, what type of shortening do you use? You know, with all the bands, trans fat, this fat, no fat, whatever the hell. So I'll provide a link below so that you can understand, all right? And remember our puree? Bam, we're adding 1 tablespoon. Y'all, this is gonna come together so nicely. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to see y'all make this recipe. So I'm also gonna add some vodka to this. I'm also gonna add some strawberry extract to this, as you'll see, and everything just comes together nicely. But this is kind of like a triple berry buttercream, because we're gonna be getting berries from the puree, we're gonna be getting berries from the strawberry extract that I'm going to be adding, and then we're gonna be getting berries from our last little tip that I have for you guys, and you will see shortly. So just go ahead and mix that, make sure that everything is nice and combined. You don't want any large clumps or anything like that. And if you're using a stand mixer, then praise be, honey, because it's going to come out a hell of a lot easier for you. I'm kind of getting used to this mixer though now, y'all. It's crazy. But anywho, so I went ahead and added my extract, I added the rest of my powdered sugar, and that's going to come together nicely. And then see how my beaters are standing at attention? That's what you want, ladies. And bam, this is what you want too. See these? Oh y'all, freeze-dried fruit in a buttercream? Yes, honey. And if you don't have freeze-dried fruit, you can also get you a fruit powder or something like that, but that really just amplifies that flavor. I mean, it's just like a burst of goodness in your mouth, you know. And I love a burst of anything delicious. So what we want to do is go ahead and fold those in. I always like to add them in towards the end, but you want to fold it in. And like I said, I just always like to double check to not make sure there's any clumps, because even though this recipe yields 12, I do this professionally. So when you're baking, you know, 100 or 200, you get kind of aggravated if a clump gets into your piping bag. All right. So that's why I like to just make sure it is nice and smooth and everything comes together perfectly for my buttercream. Okay. Now use the open tip. That's the tip that I have for you guys. And that way we know that those strawberries are going to flow perfectly and nothing is going to get clogged up in our little piping hole or piping tip hole. So go ahead and use an open tip, and y'all know I love French tips. All right, and bam, see how that comes together? I didn't add any artificial color. See those flecks? They are beautiful on their own. Soul glow berries. All right, now here's the second tip. You're like, soul glow, what the hell is that? See that strawberry fruit spread? When I used to work in more professional bakeries and when I managed some, we always have a glazer, especially at Costco. We had this big glazer that held apricot glaze. And the reason why we would lightly glaze things is because you want them to shine. For my students who bake for profit, you know, people eat with their eyes. You've heard me say that before. And a lot of you guys are always like, Chef, how do you not get the berry to leak? How do you stop the berry from leaking? Well, one step is to pat it fully dry. And then the second step is, bam, this stuff right here. All I simply did was take a tablespoon and I heated it in the microwave for about 10 to 15 seconds. And you're going to lightly brush that. You see that? Oh my gosh, baby. Whoo, look at that, y'all. That is like baby oil for your berries. I started to say KY, but it's like baby oil. But what it's going to do is just going to get your strawberries on really nice and really moist. But it's not going to make them run because the glaze is kind of a little bit more thicker. And if you don't have a glaze on hand, you could definitely use a corn syrup. I know for all my apple heads, y'all probably have corn syrup on hand. But go ahead and do it. This is an extra step, but honey, anything worth doing is worth overdoing. And that quote actually comes from my mentor, Damon John, who I love. So go ahead and lightly brush these. It's going to stop them from running. It's going to make sure they shine. And your cupcakes are going to be looking on fleek. All right, y'all. See? Look how beautiful they look. Absolutely. So our cupcakes are coming out. And what we're going to do is go ahead and brush those with our VODKA. And that's just a little extra tip that I like to do. So just go ahead and reserve some VODKA, and we're just going to lightly brush the tops. If you want to take a toothpick and just kind of stick the tops a little bit so that more of that VODKA gets into the cupcake, you absolutely can. But as you can see, they bake nice and evenly flat. They're going to be super moist. Turn to the side so you can see. Yes, awesome sauce, honey. Oh my gosh, y'all. Look at them soul glow berries. Look, I told y'all, man. I can't wait to see you guys' pictures because your berries are going to be popping. Oh, go ahead on, Amanda. I iced that perfectly. You guys, look how quick this came together. Wow. These things are so cute. They're perfect for picnics, perfect for parties, perfect for entertaining guests. You are going to love this recipe. Now, here's my last tip. See those liners for my clients, those who don't like to buy other type of liners? Look at this. Bam. Go ahead, and what you want to do is you can just simply add another liner. And that's one way to make your cupcakes really cute, especially if you do dessert tables or professional tables or stuff like that. It's kind of like a little skirt for a cupcake. Isn't that so adorable? So I got that tip from my buddy Mindy, and I've been doing it with my cupcakes ever since, and I like it. And plus, y'all know that the white liners are like the cheapest. So go ahead and use two, all right, baby? Make them look cute. Top that off. Oh, y'all, look at that. That is so adorable. Thanks so much, y'all. I hope y'all love these strawberry lemonade cupcakes. I can't wait to see. And hey, be sure to hit that like button, damn it, and hit that big ass red subscribe too. If you've come this far, I really appreciate you for rocking with me, y'all. Thanks so much, and leave a comment below as to what you'd like to see me do next.